ठक्कर बैक टू यू विद एसएस स्टैंडर्ड 7th
एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द स्टेट. वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ आवर कंट्री फंक्शंस एट 3 लेवल्स, लोकल लेवल, स्टेट लेवल एंड सेंट्रल लेवल. इन द प्रीवियस ईयर वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन. In this chapter, we shall learn about how the administration functions at the state level in a democracy. What are the functions of state government? What are the roles of ministers and members of legislative assembly? How do people put forward their questions and ideas to the government? How do they ask the fulfillment of their demands? To understand more about these questions, we shall take the example of medical field. Here, children, last year we have learned about local self-government, right? And this year we are going to learn more about the administration of the state. And we even know about the 3 function levels, that is local level, state level, central level. And we are going to learn some more ideas about the government and the fulfillment of their demands. To understand this, we are going to move forward and we are going to take the examples of the pandemic these days going on with COVID-19. You all know, according to the news, the people died due to the pandemic. And you all know the things how we must take care about and not affected by these. Now, do you think that the people really die due to the epidemic? Yes, if they don't take care of. And now let's move on that how the administration take the immediate measures to control the epidemic. They should pay the attention to maintain cleanliness, take steps and stop the epidemic from spreading. And yes, we have seen them on the TV that how the people help us for to be saved from the epidemic. The legislative members are known as MLA or members of legislative assembly. MLAs are directly elected by people. After being elected from their constituency, they become the MLAs and form the government. Thus, we can conclude that MLAs are the representative of the people. Now, all the states of India have a legislative assembly. Each state is divided into different constituencies. From each constituency, one representative is elected by the people. The number of the seats in legislative assembly differs from state to state and it is decided on the base of population. Elections are held every 5 years. Candidates can either represent a particular party or stand for election as an independent candidate. Thus, the MLAs can belong to the different parties. The Legislative Assembly of Gujarat has 182 seats and it is situated in Gandhinagar, which is the capital. The Legislative Assembly meets in Vitthalbhai Patel Vidhan Sabha Gruh. So here, children, it is said that all the states of India have Legislative Assembly. Each state is divided into different constituencies. One member of each constituency is selected through election. This member is called Member of Legislative Assembly or MLA. The number of members varies from state to state. It is decided according to the population of state. Thus, each state have different number of seats in Legislative Assembly. And there are 182 seats in Legislative Assembly of Gujarat. Hence, it is clear that MLAs together form a Legislative Assembly and hence this is the government. Now, let's learn about how minister or chief minister is selected from among the MLAs. The party which has largest number of MLAs or gain the majority with the support of other parties or independent candidates forms the government. The governor appoints the leader of majority party as the chief minister. He or she is invited to form the council of ministers. The party that forms government is known as ruling party, while the other parties form the opposition party. So here, children, we have learned that the government appoints the leader of majority party of the chief. Majority is what? That is MLAs. The party which has largest number of MLAs gains the majority. And here it is said that he or she is invited for the Council of Ministers and the party forms the government, which is known as ruling party. Now, after elections, the governor appoints the chief minister and the council of ministers who will be collectively responsible for the administration of the state and the functions of various ministries. Each ministry is housed in different office premises. The Legislative Assembly is the place where all MLAs belonging to both the ruling parties and the opposition assemble for discussions. Many MLAs have dual responsibilities as an MLA and as a minister. The other organ of state government is the executive, which comprises of governor, the chief minister and the council of ministers. The administrative officials who work under the guidance and control of ministers are also a part of executive body. The council ministers are called government executives, while the administrative officials are known as administrative executives. So here, children, it is said that the government formed of political party which is in majority. Thus, the political party in majority forms ruling party, and the leader of ruling party becomes the chief minister. Then the chief minister is invited to form cabinet. Then the cabinet consists of council of ministers who will assist these chief minister in the administration of the state. Thus, the chief minister and his other ministers are responsible for the administration of the state and different ministries. In some cases, MLAs have double responsibilities. Dual responsibilities means they have double responsibilities, and one as MLA and the other as the minister also. And on the other hand, it is said that the state government is the executive. That is, the council of ministers are known as government executives, while the administrative officials are known as administrative executives. Now, let's start with the governor. Each state of India has a governor. He or she is appointed by the president for 5 years after consulting the prime minister. The government is the constitutional head of the state, and the entire administration is carried out in his or her name. The governor ensures that the state government function according to the constitution. The functions of the governor are: invites the leader of majority party to form the government, administers the oath of loyalty to the constitution of the secrecy, calls the legislative assembly in session and also announces its adjournment. Every bill passed by the state legislature has to receive the governor's assent. However, money bills required his prior approval. A bill undergoes 3 readings and in the legislative assembly before it's passed. Following this, it is sent to the governor before it becomes a law. If a bill is not signed by governor and is sent back to Vidhan Sabha with his suggestions, then MLAs have to debate on these suggestions. The revised bill is sent back to the governor for his signature. In an emergency, the governor can issue orders called ordinances, appoints the judges for all the courts that work under the High Court, informs to the president about the functioning of the president about the functioning of state government. So children, here it is said that governor, what is governor? First of all, that each state has its governor. The governor is the constitutional head of the state, and all the administration of the state is done in the name of the government. The governor is to the state is what a president is to the nation. Thus, governor holds a very important place in the state. The president of the nation appoints governor of the state after consulting the prime minister. The term of the office to the governor is 5 years. The governor is appointed so that the state government functions according to the rules of constitution. Now it is said, what are the functions of government? The first function, that is, invite the leader to the majority party to form the government. Then appoint the chief minister. Then ask chief minister and his cabinet to take oath and be responsible and loyal to maintain secrecy towards the constitutions. Then they even call an adjourned meetings. They pass bills in the legislative assembly, pass financial bills, sign bills by the legislative assembly so that the bill becomes the law. Pass ordinance in the case of emergency. Elect judges of all the courts under the High Court. Inform about the working of state to the central government. Now, let's go with the Chief Minister. The Chief Minister is the head of the Council of Ministers, a very important position in state government. He or she is called the CM. The functions of the Chief Ministers are allotting portfolios to different ministers for the effective administration of the state, calling for meetings of Council of Ministers at regular intervals, supervising the work of every minister and guiding them, informing the governor about decisions taken by the Council of Ministers, forming a new Council of Ministers if necessary. So the Council of Ministers frame policies for allotted subject or departments related to the state government and executes it. It also introduces the bill in legislative assembly. The financial minister of the state introduces the budget in the legislative assembly. The work to be done is divided between the state and the central government. The state government functions at the state level and the union government functions at the union national level. So now here it is said that each state of India has the chief minister. The chief minister is the head of the cabinet. He plays the important role in the state government. The chief minister is to a state what the prime minister is to the nation. The leader of ruling party of the state is appointed as the chief minister by the governor. The term of the office of chief minister is also 5 years. And now, what are the functions of chief minister? Now, the functions of chief minister, first of all, it is appoint the council of ministers, then allot different ministers to different ministries and administration of the states, then observe and guide the ministers, then call meetings at regular intervals, then inform the governor about all the decisions taken by the cabinet and reform cabinet if it is in need. The difference between the state and central government is the area in which they fall. The responsibility of a state government is limited to the particular state. For example, the work of Gujarat state government is limited to its boundary, whereas the central government takes care of entire nation. The functions and powers of state and central government are divided into three lists, that is the union list, state list and concurrent list. Concurrent list means that is combined list. Okay, the subjects includes in this list are mentioned in the constitution. Now children, here it is said that the functions and the power of states and the central state are divided into three lists as given below: union list, state list and combined list, or you can say concurrent list. So these lists are as given below, that is I said, and various subjects are included in these lists, and the union or the states have given no functions accordingly. These lists have been mentioned in our constitution. Now here it is said union list. So you can see there are 97 subjects in union list. The subject mentioned in the union list are to be handled by central government. Various subjects like census, relations with foreign countries, defense, banking and finance, elections, formations of law for citizens, telegraph, postal service, insurance service, nuclear power services, sea, rail, road, air services, etc. are included in the list of union. Now we moving on to the state list. There are 66 subjects in state list. The subject mentioned in the state list are to be handled by the Legislative Assembly and the members of the cabinet. So various subjects like health, agriculture, forest, local self-rule institutes, panchayat, etc. are included in this list as given in the book. Then it is said combined list. Now combined list is, that is, concurrent list. That is, there are 47 subjects in this combined list. The combined list is also called concurrent list. The subject mentioned in the combined list are to be jointly or individually handled by the union government or central government as well as the state government as concurrent list, that is combined list. Both the state government and central government form laws for the subject mentioned in this list. Various subjects like crime, tax or revenue, divorce, literacy, industry, employment, electricity, etc. are included in this list. Legislative Assembly. Marina, Imran and other students of their school were very excited about the trip to Gandhinagar, the capital of Gujarat, where they were going to see the Legislative Assembly. After the security check, they went upstairs. There were arrangements made for visitors from where they could see the grand hall downstairs. A sitting arrangement of members of Legislative Assembly was made in that meeting hall. On that day, the current issues was to be discussed in the Legislative Assembly. Usually, in the Legislative Assembly, the MLAs can express their views during a question-answer session. They can ask questions and give suggestions. The members give their feedback on the issues being discussed. Then the concurrent ministers answer the questions and brief them about the measures being taken to solve the issue. We often come across on the television or in newspaper that decisions are taken by chief ministers and other ministers in order to run the government. While taking a decision about anything, it is necessary to take the permission of the MLAs. In a democracy, the MLAs can question the chief minister and other ministers and discuss about the important matters. So here, children, it is said, representative of general public, they have right to question the government of its working. During the session of Legislative Assembly, the MLAs express their views on the topic being discussed. They ask questions related to the topic, also give suggestions for the same. They can give their feedback on the measures taken by government. Indian being a democratic nation, the MLAs have full authority to question the chief minister as well as council ministers. In return, the concerned minister is bound to answer the question of MLA. It has to give the satisfactory clarification of the issues raised by the MLA. It is necessary that the cabinet take permissions of MLAs before taking any decision. In addition to this, the MLAs can take decision regarding budget and financials of the state. They can also decide how much expenditure can be done in different areas. Thus, MLAs plays an important role in Legislative Assembly. Now, they can even take decisions regarding financial matters and decide on the expenditure to be done by different areas. When the Legislative Assembly is in session, any of the MLAs can ask questions. The Speaker manages the Assembly One requires his permission before presenting anything. See, children, here, as I said, that they can even ask questions. They can even take decisions regarding the budget and financials of the states. And now here it said about the Speaker. The Speaker is the highest authority who manages the Legislative Assembly. He commands the session of Legislative Assembly and conducts its proceedings. Before presenting anything in the session, the member have to seek permission of the speaker. All the members have to obey the speaker also. Here, I end the chapter. Thank you. Bye.